everyone, welcome back. Hope your studies are going good. So today we are going to study the topic that is liver cirrhosis. Okay, so before we begin with the topic, you just have to keep in mind one thing, that this is the normal liver which we have. You know, it is very smooth surface, it is very glossy in appearance, but this is a cirrhotic liver, or a liver which has been having cirrhosis. So you see, there are so many nodules formation in this liver, right? So this is a liver which has been suffering from cirrhosis. Going into deep of the topic, what is liver cirrhosis? Liver cirrhosis is mainly a disorder which is related to progressive diffuse hepatic fibrosis and nodule formation. So what happens is, this is a healthy liver. Now slowly and slowly there will be fibrous tissue which will start generating inside this healthy liver. Also there will be nodule formation which will give rise to a condition known as liver cirrhosis. If the condition liver cirrhosis is being prolonged for more period of time, it can lead into hepatic carcinoma. Okay, so this is what the whole strategy or the whole plan is about. So it is how a healthy liver is being changing into a carcinoma condition. So you see, what is liver cirrhosis? It is a disorder in which there is diffuse hepatic fibrosis. You know what fibrosis is, and nodule formation. These are the two things you need to keep in mind. Fibrosis and nodule formation in the liver is said to be liver cirrhosis. Moving ahead, this complication can occur at any age. There's no particular age, but what is the important causes which can lead to this particular condition? So people who have this habit of consuming alcohol, and that too from a very prolonged period of time, and that too in a very excessive condition, they are at the most high risk. Okay, so people who have prolonged alcohol history consumption are basically related to this. Now also, people who are suffering from chronic viral hepatitis B and C, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, primary biliary cirrhosis, cryptogenic causes are basically some hidden causes, and the autoimmune hepatitis. So these are few risk factors, or these are few conditions, and people suffering from these conditions are basically at the risk factor. Now coming to the pathophysiology, how is this liver cirrhosis actually happening? So in general condition, when I made you see the picture of a healthy liver, you saw it was so smooth and so glossy in appearance. So normally there is no fibrous tissue in the liver, okay? Our liver does not contain any fibrous tissue or any nodule in a normal condition. So there is no fibrous tissue in the liver in a normal condition. But for example, an injury happened in the liver, okay? And because of that injury, what will happen is, the stellate cells of the liver will get converted into the myofibroblast cells because of the action of cytokines. So this is happening. Now the stellate star-shaped cells are getting converted into myofibroblasts. These myofibroblast cells are going to release collagen, okay? They are going to release some fibers, collagen, which will kind of cause fibrosis condition into the liver, which will further lead to the distortion of the normal architecture of the liver. So you got what the whole procedure is about. There was no fibrous tissue found in normal condition, but then we saw there were no fibrous tissue in normal condition, but then any liver injury happened. Because of the liver injury, the stellate cells are getting converted into the myofibroblast cells by the action of cytokines. Now these myofibroblast cells are going to release collagen, and fibrosis condition is going to happen, which will further lead to the disturbance or distortion of the normal liver architecture. So you can see into the picture, this is how a normal liver looks like, and this is a liver which is having cirrhosis. So there are so many nodules and fibrous tissue which can be seen. The architecture of the liver is completely distorted. Moving ahead, liver cirrhosis can be of two types. It can be micronodular or it can be macronodular. Now you very well know what is micro, small, macro means large. So when the diameter is less than 1 mm or about 1 mm, then it is said to be small nodules or micronodular liver cirrhosis. And whenever the nodule diameter is more than 1 mm, then that condition is said to be the macronodular liver cirrhosis. Now you have to keep in mind that these nodule and the fibers which are being formed are the characteristic key feature of liver cirrhosis. So you can see how the liver looks like. Coming to the clinical features, so in general condition, you will see that there are no symptoms in the patient. That means the patient will be asymptomatic in most of the conditions. But if the specific symptoms have occurred, then the specific symptoms will be very, very mild, and sometimes they will be so weak that you would not be able to classify them as a particular symptom of liver cirrhosis, like weakness, fatigue, muscle cramp, weight loss, anorexia, vomiting, nausea, and upper abdominal distress. These are basically symptoms which we experience in our day-to-day life also because of poor lifestyle, right? So there is nothing very, very specific which can make us identify that this condition is a liver cirrhosis condition. So these are some of the general symptoms or the non-specific symptoms which can be seen. Otherwise, the patient will be most of the time asymptomatic only. But if I talk about the signs of liver cirrhosis, then hepatomegaly can be seen, hard irregular surface can be seen, jaundice can be seen, and palmar arrhythmia can be seen. And if I talk particularly about the endocrinal signs and symptoms, then in males you will see there will be conditions like gynecomastia. You very well know what gynecomastia is: testicular atrophy, impotence, loss of libido, and hair loss. These are some of the specific endocrinal features or signs which can be seen in liver cirrhosis for males. Now for females, there can be breast atrophy, hemorrhage, bruises, purpura, loss of libido, and hair loss. So this is what a purpura looks like, right? So these are some specific signs for the endocrinal changes. These were the general signs which can be seen, and these are the general symptoms. I would really appreciate if you can answer this question and tell me in the comment section that what is the difference between a sign and a symptom. Let me see how many of you know the right answer. Okay, moving ahead, what are the complications of liver cirrhosis? Now, liver cirrhosis can further give rise to many other complications. The first one is ascites. Now, ascites is basically a condition in which there is fluid accumulation in the abdominal cavity. Now, you see in the picture here, this is the normal abdomen. There is no fluid accumulation here, the normal organs, the normal structure, the normal architecture. Whereas this is the ascites abdomen. In this you can see that there is fluid all accumulated in the abdominal, periabdominal cavity, which leads to excessive swelling of the abdomen region. This is known as ascites. It is basically fluid accumulation in the abdomen region. And then another complication is portal hypertension, hepatorenal syndrome, hepatic carcinoma, clubbing, pigmentation, jaundice, and hepatic encephalopathy. So these are some of the complications of the liver cirrhosis. Coming to the treatment, the very first thing we are supposed to do is remove the triggering factor. If the person is prolonged alcoholic, ask the patient to leave the alcohol consumption. And the next thing we have to do is that for treatment of particularly the complications, like for example for ascites, as you know, there is water or accumulation into the abdomen region. So what we need to do is we will restrict the water and sodium intake of the patient, and we will give diuretics. You know, diuretics are the drugs which help in frequent urination so that the excess of the water can be removed out of the body. Also, we can go for TIPS surgery, which can be done. And other than that, there is a stem cell implantation or stem cell surgery which can be done. What do we do in this surgery is we are going to infuse some stem cells into the liver, which will help in regenerating the damaged liver. So you will see that with time throughout this therapy, the liver will start getting back to normal conditions slowly and slowly. So this was the treatment which we can do for the liver cirrhosis. So this was all about liver cirrhosis. I hope this video was useful to you. Also answer me in the comment section that what do you think is the difference between a sign and a symptom. And share this video with your friends and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.